Hi dear students, hope you all are doing good. As you all know that I am presenting some videos on post gate. Some of the students in YouTube comments, they are asking the question like, sir, please explain what is the difference between M.Tech and M.S. So I would like to take the opportunity here. In the next 15 minutes, I will clearly explain what is the major difference between M.S. program and M.Tech program in IITs as well as NITs. So before going to the point, I would like to mention this thing. This particular video is helpful to mechanical students, instrumentation students, ECE students, electrical students, civil students, what not. It is actually important to everyone. So I request all of you just pay attention for 10 to 15 minutes. You will understand clearly the difference between MS and M.Tech. Now let me start like this. So if you see here, I have just listed out the classical difference between the M.Tech and MS and Integrated PhD in terms of different parameters. So first of all, if you look at all these three, M.Tech as well as MS and Integrated PhD falls in the category of higher studies. You and me, everybody knows that. Now, if you look at this, Master of Technology is purely academic oriented course and it takes 2 years of time, but when it comes to MS and Integrated PhD, both are a kind of research oriented. Now let me tell you important thing here, that is GATE score required to get M.Tech admission. If I define that as X, suppose let us take an example. If you want to get production specialization in IIT Madras, let us say you require 850 GATE score, but in the same IIT Madras, to get production department, MS, you need not to have 850 GATE score. Actually, it is sufficient to get a GATE score of 600 to 700 maximum. But if you are actually interested in pursuing Integrated PhD, it is sufficient even if you get GATE score bit less. Less in the sense like 500 and 600, 500 to 600, somewhere around like that. Now, the most important thing here is, if you look at course theme wise, course theme wise in the sense what exactly you will going to do in M.Tech and MS. As I was saying from the previous videos also, M.Tech is purely academic oriented. You all guys knows that in B.Tech, mostly you will going to study 40 to 46 subjects and you will do one mini project in the third year ending, and in the final semester you will do one main project. But in the case of Master of Technology, that is M.Tech, you are going to study almost around 10 to 12 subjects. Again, one project will be there. In some of the colleges, final semester will be project, and in some of the colleges, second year is completely dedicated to the project one. So again, like B.Tech program, unlike the number of subjects, you are going to study around 10 to 12 subjects. Again, in Master of Technology also. Suppose, if a student joined in Mechanical Engineering, B.Tech, he will study thermal engineering, he will also study about production, manufacturing and heat transfer and everything, thermodynamics. But when you come to the masters, if you select only production especially as your specialization, then you will going to study all the topics related to only production engineering. That means when you come down or when you go up from B.Tech, you will going to study many subjects, but when it comes to Master of Technology, your focus will be only related to certain field, only related to some topics. But when it comes to MS, as I was saying previously also, it is bit less academic but more research kind of oriented. Because the moment when you join in MS program in any of the colleges, either it might be a IIT or NIT, immediately once you join in the MS program, either you should choose a guide or you should choose a professor as a guide, or the institute will going to offer a professor as your guide. So you need to talk with your guide, and based on the guide's project or else based on the professor's project and professor's work, the particular professor will ask you, go and study these four subjects. Then you should complete those four subjects, whatever the professor is mentioning, in one semester and remaining four semesters. Because I already told you, MS will going to take minimum 2.5 years to 3 years. So first one semester, you should prepare or you should go through 4 to 5 subjects which are related to the professor's work, and then remaining 2 years, you will be completely working on that project. And as I said, as you are almost investing 2 years of your time only in single project, that's why I mentioned that this is more of research kind of oriented. And when it comes to integrated PhD, almost around 1 year, 1 year or 1.5 year, mostly it is related to academic oriented, and almost you can consider first 1.5 year is like equivalent to the Master of Technology, that is M.Tech. After that, your real project will going to start. Once your real project starts, then obviously the difficulty level will be increased, and it is almost into the research oriented, because at the end of this course, you will going to get a doctorate certificate. Naturally, you should do good research. If you join in IESC, then you know, IESC actually demands a lot of research work from you. And next thing is coming to the duration level. Duration in the sense how many years it takes to complete the particular course. Now, when it comes to duration, M.Tech in any college, that is either the IISc or it might be IIT or it might be NIT, any college, it will going to take 2 years, and it is a fixed time. Unless until you face some difficulty, it is actually a fixed time. 2 years is a fixed duration. Now when it comes to MS, average it will going to take 2.5 years and maximum it will take 3 years, and sometimes it may be more than that. It depends on, you know, like compatibility between your project work and a guide's expectation, that is professor's expectation. If you are not doing good enough, then your course duration may be increased to 3.5 years also. This point you should remember before joining into MS course, because most of the students, once they enter into the MS course, unknowingly they will be struck there. Okay, so if you do really good work and if you satisfy your project professor's demand, and if you do good work in the research, then obviously you can finish everything in 2.5 years of section. And when it comes to integrated PhD, if you do extraordinary work, your integrated PhD course might be completed in 4.5 years, including thesis work also, or else it may take more than 5 years also, because when it is research oriented course, the duration is not fixed, it is actually a dynamic parameter. It all depends on your professor, because if you get results immediately, then you can convince the professor after publishing some papers. If you are not getting the results immediately, then obviously the duration will going to increase. This means that the research oriented courses purely under the in the hands of professor. So you should select a good professor, that is what I mean to say. And when it comes to process, difficulty level, this is also one of the important thing, because most of the students generally they ask this question to me. Difficulty level, actually M.Tech, it is not actually fixed, because you should understand these things. Same course will not be taught in the same way in different institutions. Suppose if you take production in IIT Madras, it may be difficult to complete, but in IIT Delhi, it may be a bit easy compared to IIT Madras. For example, I am saying, it is not actually that, you know, like a fixed statement. This is why I cannot rate whether it is a difficult one or easy one, because it actually depends on what specialization you are taking and what college you are selecting. But when it comes to MS, whatever the college you select, whether it might be IIT or whether it might be old IIT or new IIT or NIT, anything, MS is moderately tough, because you should understand this thing. When you select MS as your course, then surely you should do some research and you should produce some results which are better than the existing ones. This is primary aim once you enter into MS course. That's why I mentioned like it is moderately high. And when it comes to integrated PhD, naturally it will be high, because you need to do more work, and almost majorly 80% of your course demands the research from you, whatever the college you select. That is different story. Clear? So now the next immediate factor is procedure of admission. Yeah, this is also one of the most common question I used to get, procedure of admission. If you look at here, if you want to get into M.Tech course in IIT, then first thing, based on the GATE score, you should apply to the IIT, particular IIT. Then IIT will shortlist the applications and call the selected students for the interview. And again, you need to go to the particular IIT. And once you go to the particular IIT, then you should face the personal interview. And based on your GATE score as well as personal interview, together, IIT will go into shortlist you for M.Tech course. This is about the procedure. But when it comes to NIT, personal interview will not be there. It is straight away based on your GATE score. So actually it is quite easy to get the admission in NIT, because NIT don't have the personal interview. That is about M.Tech. But when it comes to MS, you look at here clearly. MS, if you are trying to get into MS course, either in IESE or in IIT, or it might be NIT, whatever may be the college, these three will going to constitute the admission process. First one is GATE score, and the second one is written test. Means you should go to that particular IIT or NIT and you should attend for one written test, and if you perform well in the written test, you will be shortlisted to the interview. And if you are not performing well in the written test, you will be booked the written ticket, so you should go to your home once again. Okay, so if you do well in all these three, then the admission will be provided in MS course in IESE or IIT or NIT. So getting MS is comparatively is a lengthy process, because you need to go through the written test. But of course GATE score is a bit low, because GATE score, most of the people in India, you know, like they are not too much interested to research oriented. That's why the volume of the students who are applying for MS program is comparatively low. That's why there is a chance to get MS easily if you do well in the personal interview at least. And then when it comes to integrated PhD, almost the admission procedure is similar to the MS program. So again, you need to go through the written test in that particular IIT or NIT, once you reach to that particular IIT or NIT, and then again you need to attend the personal interview. But as I said earlier, the GATE score required for integrated PhD is comparatively less with respect to MS, and it will be less with respect to again Masters, that is M.Tech. Now coming to the next point, number of times per year a student can apply. Actually, M.Tech admissions will be taken in the month of July. Hopefully it will be in the month of July. Almost all IITs and NITs will go into allow the admissions in the month of July. So per year it will be only once, because you all know that in the month of March, most probably in the second week of the March, results will be out and you will go for interview process, all this, blah, blah, blah. At the end, mostly in the month of July, you will going to get the admission, final call letter from IIT or NIT. But when it comes to MS and integrated PhD, the admission will be open twice in a year. Twice in a year in the sense, there is January admission and as well as July admission. January admission in the sense, notification will be released in December in the particular academic year, and those students who got selected in the interview, they will be allotted their admission in the month of January. And July admission in the sense, notification will be released in the month of April and the process will be completed. Then by the month of July first week, the students are allowed to take their MS as well as integrated PhD course in that particular respective IIT or NIT. This is the story related to admission process, I mean number of times per year. And when it comes to the opportunities, and finally, I want to take some time here to explain, because it is one of the famous questions. Almost after another 20 days, many students will go into message only on this thing. What are the going to be the opportunities if I study MS? So listen one thing clearly. If you study B.Tech, in B.Tech, you are going to cover so many subjects. Then the scope will be more. The diversity will be more. When you come to Masters, your field will be selected. When you select MS, then that particular selected field will be narrowed down. And if you select integrated PhD, then everything will going to be only on single topic. That means B.Tech and M.Tech and then MS and then PhD. So when you actually do integrated PhD, almost 3.5 to 4 years you will going to work only on single topic, clear? Then obviously the opportunities will be narrowed down, because here in B.Tech you will going to have wide opportunities. When it is M.Tech, as your topic is so specific, the opportunities will be less. When you select MS, then opportunities will be still less. But as I mentioned earlier, this MS as well as integrated PhD, both are research oriented. Obviously, you are going to have more opportunities in research labs like DRDO, ISRO, as well as CSIR, all these things, all these labs, research labs. And definitely, if you do good work under your professor, and if your professor also done good work, then obviously the chances of getting into ISRO as well as DRDO and even again IAS PhD admission or else even CSIR, the options will be more to you. And one more thing I want to tell you, if you actually do good work in MS under any professor, under any IIT, in any IIT, then naturally the professor will going to ask you whether you are interested in PhD or not, pursuing PhD or not. Because professor always expects a good student. If a student done real extraordinary work in MS, naturally he will going to give preference for PhD admission. So those students who actually done masters, their opportunities will be open in research labs or else R&D department in very big companies like Samsung, Qualcomm. Almost every industry will going to have an R&D lab. In that particular R&D lab, they will going to prefer. If your work in masters, that is MS, matches with the company profile and company demand, then you will be taken into the R&D labs with a huge package sometimes. And sometimes the package what MS students gets into R&D is comparatively higher than M.Tech students package. But it is very rare condition. Only specific students used to get those things. And naturally, as I said, if you do really good work in your MS, professor will going to offer the admission to PhD also, because he will be very interesting to take you for the PhD program. That is about MS. Now, when it comes to integrated PhD, as usually, it is also related to the research, first of all. So you will going to have the opportunity in research labs. Once again, I am repeating this statement. Research labs in the sense DRDO as well as ISRO and CSIR labs and all these things. And again, you will also have R&D, research and development wing of any in a good industry. And then obviously the final field is teaching. Because you know, like you will go, if you really do good, if you do with the good grades and good strong commendable knowledge in a particular field in ISC, then obviously you will going to have opportunity to teach in IIT and NIT. If you do very well integrated PhD in IIT, then there is a chance to teach in NITs. Clear? And last point I want to tell you this, from my past students' experience, I came to know this point. That is, most of the students, they used to pursue this their masters, that is MS in research, in any of the IITs. Once they do a commendable work in particular IIT, then immediately they will apply PhD for a PhD admission in foreign universities. Because if you do MS in Indian universities, that is IESE and IIT and NIT, definitely you will be able to do some commendable work, and that particular commendable work is sufficient to get admission in foreign university in PhD course. That is also one of the beautiful path that the students are having. So what my suggestion is, because most of the people always has the dilemma whether to go for MS or not. See, it is very simple. If your GATE score is low and you want to do your higher studies only from reputed colleges, and you are also partially interested in research, then I suggest you go and opt for that. If you are not at all interested in research, you are only interested in academic part, then my suggestion is don't look at these two options. You just select whatever the college you want. Okay, this is all about the clear difference between M.Tech and MS and integrated PhD. So in upcoming videos, I am going to explain the BARC interview process and IOCL interview process as well as ONGC interview process, because many students are regularly messaging me. So my suggestion is next few days, stay connected to me. I will explain about all these details in brief. Thank you.